Alright everyone, here is a Legacy Burn deck list I just ran through a league. Pretty standard list, bunch of 4 ofs, 1 Grim Lavamancer, 1 Barbarian Ring. Sideboard, that's where Legacy Burn differs a little bit. Added another Lavamancer for creature matchups, Pyroblast for the blue decks, Smash for Chalice and Artifact decks. Parasite Pillar's pretty good against Storm and Delver and Miracles. Sulfuric Vortex for Miracles, Delver, and the Bridge for all your big creature decks. So let's run through some of the games. Really happy with this list and the way it turned out. I had to keep a greedy one lander, but I got a lot of one drops, so just gotta hit a second land. The guide. This motor replay is so terrible. Out of Chalice, I feel a little bad here, but he's going to take a lot of damage from his Ancient Tomb. I've already got a 2-2 down, so it's not all those that I've lost. Get lucky, draw my other land, can't play anything else. Run that out. He's taking more damage from Ancient Tomb. Really not sure what I'm playing against now. I thought it might have been Stompy or Eldrazi, but I had to look this up and it turns out it was Mud. Spells I can't play. Oops. Sorry. Now I know he was on Mud, and I don't know why he cast this into this. So, key point here is that I waited for him to equip this first, so my Searing Blaze would be on the stack on top of it. And that way this would get destroyed without fizzling. He would still take 3 damage from the blaze if I didn't do it that way, because they target each separately. But I wanted this gone because I didn't want him to ramp into something bigger. So my blaze goes on the stack, and then he just concedes. So, sideboard, I just brought in the bridges and the smashed smithereens that I took out the searing blazes. Another great opening hand. This Price of Progress can do work against this deck since they don't play any basics. But he leads on a wasteland, but he's going to use that, need to use that to actually use it for mana. Because he's a colorless deck. So, definitely a keep. Run out the Goblin Guide. Run out the Swift Sphere because they're essentially going to be the same card right here. And I remove their Metal Worker because I don't want them to ramp. What they'll do is they'll tap this, add a bunch of mana, and then untap it with the Voltaic Key. So that had to go. And then he's still taking tons of damage from that Ancient Tomb. And then just run it out. And that's why you play Legacy Burn. 12 damage on turn 3. Played a lot of weird decks and against a lot of weird decks this league. Definitely a keep. Wish you'd like to have a turn 1 creature, but you can't pass up Eidolon and Searing Blaze in your opening hand. So, Basic Island could be a lot of things. Still not really sure what I'm up against. Now I'm getting a little bit confused. Because it's not Grixis and it's not Miracles. But I looked it up and it turned out to be, once the Innocent Blood went down, I saw it was Standstill. So they don't play a lot of counter spells, so I'm just trying to get out my Eidolon before they lock me with Standstill. Always attack first with your Eidolon, because if they remove it, you won't take the damage. Cast your spells in the second main. I get rid of the Snapcaster, because this Eidolon's going to be doing work. He has to find the combos, the block pieces. Now he can't really stand still anymore. So this game I just brought in a bunch of Pyroblasts and took out the Searing Blaze. And I brought in the pillars too, and took out the Lavamancer. Run out this guy. Hopefully you can get some work done. I choose not to run out the Eidolon here because I don't really have a lot of cards and I really need to make sure he doesn't counter it. And I want to play it with Pyroblast to back it up. So I need all these spells to resolve for me to have a chance. Definitely get rid of that because that thing's annoying. Well, basically lets it makes it so I don't attack. Well, now I feel pretty good. I go ahead and counter this Force Will because again, Blueback Stancil doesn't run a lot of counters. do have a lot of removal, but I have a lot of follow-up. Don't swing with Grim Lavamancer yet. Looking to see what they play. Jace is just too late at this point. So I start going for the Dome. Managed to top deck pretty well. Get in for another two. Probably could have waited till his step to do that, but I just wanted to make it sure that he couldn't cast anything. Let's say a 2-0 start. Felt really good. Haven't even lost the match yet. Or a game. But we're playing against some janky decks, so it's a little bit of a grain of salt. A little land heavy, but we got lots of creatures. Voice of Resurgence. So I wasn't sure what this deck was either. Played against a lot of jank. Turned out to be some sort of like three color hate bears or kind of a version of Maverick. Again, I just wanted to wait because I don't really know what he's going to pop out with this vial. And it's death rate, so I'm glad I waited. Hate that card. Always remove death rate on sight, if possible. Does too much. Little land heavy. I just go ahead and do this because I have the lands anyway, and I really don't want that death rate to take over. Start gaining them life. Probably should have held on to that mountain for Searing Blaze. Didn't need it. Not targeting any of these creatures because it'll just help him ramp. So Voice of Resurgence will have a creature. It'll create an element. And these guys will create a bunch of spirits. So at this point, I don't have to block. Just yet. If I draw one burn spell here, I can just Grim Lavamancer, send it to his face. Alright, I forgot I already had the Rift Bolt on suspend. So I'm just trying to make sure that he doesn't get a bunch of tokens. So I brought in the bridges for game two. Took out some of the lava spikes. Absolute keep. Two lands and a land that helps me destroy some creatures. And a blaze, which is also important. Eidolon so-so in this matchup because they could just file things in, but they do cast stuff too. Didn't bring in Smash. I'm debating if I should play the second Eidolon or not. So I'm waiting to see if my first one lives. Also waiting to see if I could Searing Blaze something, which getting rid of Thalia is huge, so it doesn't clog our mana. And our opponent gave up. He's dead anyway. I would have out a Fire Blast on them next turn. Lightning Bolt. They have no counters for that. So 3-0. Little janky. And now I get to a real matchup. One of the premier decks in the format right now. Definitely keep this hand. Counterbalance, so we're against Miracles. Yay. Well, good thing I added the Barb Ring, and I have it, because usually what happens with Miracles is I get him down to 2 life, and then I'm locked out of the game. So, just getting in with everything. Uh-oh. Gotta love Modo. Okay, so fetch, run out the guide. Turn one creature is so huge here because they don't have a play for the first couple turns. I run out the Eidolon first because I know they're going to have to cast some stuff into it, and plus I'd rather, yeah, his turn 2 is just counterbalance, so he's going to take 6. Here's me testing to see what's on top, choose not to use it. Probably could have revealed with a... See, good thing I played the Eidolon first. Get rid of Snappy. And he concedes. So, nice fast start. On the play. Helps. So for this game, I just brought in the Pyroblast, the Pyrostatic Pillar, took out the Blazes and the Lava Spike, I think. I'll have a Cyborg Guide up at some point. We're both talking in here. I'm 3-0 at this point. He's 4-0. No need to fetch. I don't have a Grim Lavamancer. Feels bad. He paths my turn 1. I'm not casting Eidolon because he might have Counterspell. I wait for him to have mana open or mana shut to cast it, or I have Pyroblast. So just slowly chipping away. Probably should have targeted that with the Lightning Bolt, and another Eidolon is not what I needed. 2 Eidolons is really not what I needed. Made a mistake there by turning off all my mana that I couldn't Pyroblast the Jace. should have traded here too. Because now I'm behind. And that's just going to do damage to me as well. Shouldn't have attacked with him. So a couple mistakes were made on this one. The correct play would have been to hold back the first time and block one of these. But I was kind of needing to race him because I was running out of gas. And he had a Monastery Mentor down. So like I said, this matchup usually gets pretty close where you get them down, but then they get some sort of lock on you with Jace or the Mentor or a counterbalance. So I finally lost the match in round 4. On to round 3. But we're on the play. Definitely mulligan that first hand. It was nothing but lands. Keep a greedy one lander. But it has Grim Lava Mancer Guide, so we can hopefully get some damage in fast. Not the ideal hand, but hey, we're swinging in. Oh yeah, I take out the Price to Progress in this matchup too, because they play a lot of basics. Lucky draw there. Don't play for him. He flusters me. I say sure. Have a lightning bolt. Test the top of the counterbalance. This had 2 play for Flusterstorm this time, since I really rather have 3 go through. I'm really running out of gas here. But luckily I got a Barb Ring. Destroys my blue elemental. Bridge here isn't bad since it goes wide. I get rid of Snappy. I need this guide to connect. And then he concedes because he knows I just need to cast one more thing and I can chuck the Barb Ring at him. Okay, on to the last match. Good start. Oh, and we're against Reanimator. So not a good start. This is gonna be pretty rough for us. The 5-0 Dream is probably gone at this point, but we got some good sideboard tech. So he's gonna get Grizzly Brandy out. All I can do here is hope that I hit him with Rift Bolt and a bunch of Searing Blazes and get him off the board. And hope he doesn't find another thing to reanimate. Grizzly Brand number 2. Alright, never mind, you're going to be Elish Norn. So, I am pretty much dead. So, brought in the ley lines, take out the Searing Blazes, brought in the Ensnaring Bridges, took out the Lava Mancer. Dream, Start Hand, Double Ley Lines. And the Lava Spike. Makes me think he does get my idol on, but he realizes it's just going to be too slow. They do have some sideboard cards to get rid of the ley line, but probably not enough to get two. So this is it. Final round match in the final round for the 5-0 Dream. It's trying to find them ley lines, trying to find the ley line. Finally found one. And we'll keep it. You definitely got to Mulligan aggressively against this matchup. They could go off on turn one. And then my only hate card has to be in my opening hand. Just go ahead and cast that into the Chancellor. Just play out some cards so they don't Cabal Therapy it. Good, so I'm getting on a clock here. Alright, well, at least we're playing some stuff. And that's the hate card. So, unfortunately, I really needed to have another ley line. Or give him more of a clock. If I had a ley line in my opening hand instead of mulliganing to 5. And that's game right there. I can't cast anything into Iona. So, it was a good run. I'm happy with the list. Played against mainly some jank, but I think the sideboard is where a lot of Legacy Burn people differ, but online, you, without knowing who what you're up against, you need to kind of basically plan for as much as possible. I didn't record a game, but I even beat Show and Tell one time with this list, and that's probably even a worse matchup than Reanimator. I just pyroblasted his Show and Tell and had a couple beaters. I think I Ensnaring Bridge the other game, and he couldn't do anything. I think I'm going to record some more games with this list. I think I might run this in the Legacy Challenge this weekend. So, leave some comments. Thanks.